Alright guys, so as you can see here, I've set up another install on this standalone Packard Bell to be infected with the 1/2 virus on a very small partition. And I got a couple comments asking me how we would go about removing the virus properly rather than improperly, which was demonstrated last time. And I looked around and actually found on F-Secure's FTP server, there still exists a copy of a removal tool. Now, as to whether or not that will work, I have no idea because I haven't tested it. So we're going to find out live on this video. We'll see if any DOS antiviral utilities are really worth it. So, should be set up to restart one more time and then get the payload message. There we go, disk is 1/2. Alright. Disk is screwed, okay. Now, I didn't put the reboot.com and autoexecute.bat, so we're not going to see it constantly rebooting here. But we're going to go ahead and restart. Actually, we're going to power down. Set 1/2 won't infect this disk that has the tool on it. We're going to boot from MS-DOS. If I can put the disk in the slot, there we go. And I have no idea if this tool will work, as I said. It's really a mystery. It's going to be a learning experience. And really, this would be what you would have to rely on if your disk was infected with 1/2 and you wanted to clean it. Exit out of the installer. Alright, so now we got a clean version of DOS running from the floppy disk. I'm going to go ahead and try this utility out. See what we got on the disk here. So we've got a bunch of utilities, and I'm assuming 1/2.exe is meant to remove the virus, so we're going to try that out. There we go. Partition table is infected. Use 1/2/d to disinfect. See? Brings you powerful tools to protect your computer against viruses. Ooh, and powerful is flashing, so you know it's true. Alright, virus is not in memory. So I guess you could run this while the virus was present in memory from the command line without booting from a clean diskette, but it's always nice to boot from a clean diskette when you're working with master boot record viruses. So we run 1/2/d. Apparently it should clean. Whoa. Okay, what are we talking about? This virus already encrypted your disk since track number 38. If you have disk full more than 3%, some data on your hard disk are encrypted. This data can be rescued, so please proceed following steps. Write down following parameters. Good typo. That's what I like to see in an antivirus utility that I'm depending on. Let's see, track 38. Gotta write it down. I can't see in the dark to write, but we gotta write it down, otherwise our data is gone forever. Track 38. Alright. Constant 147. Okay. These parameters will be required if some problems appears after decoding data. Now going to decrypt disk. Do you want to rescue Ute disk? Alright, another typo. Let's go. We are decrypting. Don't interrupt this action. So I'm guessing it already removed it, and now it's found the key and is decrypting our disk for us. I'm surprised this actually seems to be going very smoothly. I like the colors too. See how long this takes. We're getting there. Seems to be going alright. We are decrypting now. That's a good sign. So as you can see above, I'm about the sixth line down, it has rewritten the partition table to eliminate the virus, which is good. Hopefully this does rescue our disk. Because I would be devastated if I could never run vSafe again. That would be just awful. I didn't realize it would be taking this long. Well, I guess it's better a lengthy process than losing all your data. So, if you're gonna be dealing with DOS viruses back in the day, you gotta have some patience. No fancy malware bytes, anti-malware flash scans complete in 30 seconds, none of that. No. You gotta run this stuff probably for hours on larger disks. I guess it could still be like that if you're running a full scan. I'm running out of things to just talk about. Wait, no, never mind. The red font color for important message followed by that gray text makes me think of the OpenServe virus payload. It says like note, and then you're using an illegal Microsoft Windows license. That's a good video, or a good virus. I need to make another video on that. That'll be like my fourth one, but I don't care because I love that one. I feel like I would be robbing you of the experience of this video if I just edited this out in post. I mean, you've got to be here. You've got to live with me removing the virus. I mean, this is such a rare occurrence on this channel. We don't remove viruses. We just look at them. We talk about them. Talking about viruses. But no, we are removing one. It's crazy. And it doesn't involve just wiping the disk clean. We are actually using a tool. And it just keeps going forever. And it doesn't end. Okay, seriously. I know you're trying to save my data, but could we hurry this along? It would really suck if this wound up being caught in just some random infinite loop bug, and it actually never ended. But it's still giving me hard drive activity on the LED, so I assume it's doing something, even though it just keeps going. Will the follow-up video actually be longer than the original video? Actually might. But are we done? No, just faking me out. According to my camera, it's only going to allow us to record for 16 more minutes, so let's better hurry up. Track number 500 isn't good enough. It never ends. This is a great video so far. Half of it is just silence. We have 9.5 minutes of recording time left. Yay, 1,000. Will it ever end? Oh shit, it finished. Scared the hell out of me too. There we go. If there will be problem with your programs or data, run this utility once again with /E'd1 do this action. Virus.DOS.Onehalf not found on targeted disks. Done. All right. Seems we have been clean. Let's try it again. 1.5. Virus not found. That's a good sign. All right. Let's try booting into the system. Actually, first, if the virus really is gone, we can write a new master boot record over this. And it wouldn't matter. Alright, whatever. So if our computer still boots and everything's not corrupted, this tool actually did what it advertised. Wouldn't that be something? Would you look at that? Our config file is just fine. Looks good. Can we run the command interpreter? Yes. Can we run vSafe? Yay! Oh crap, just knocked the tripod almost over, but yay! Hands up in victory. We did it. We removed a virus successfully. We didn't have to format. We didn't have to wipe the drive. Didn't have to reinstall the operating system. This tool actually did what it advertised to do. It only took almost all the recording time that I had. But that's alright. I hope you enjoyed this follow-up. Thanks for the original request, and thanks for keeping on watching my videos. I'll see you next time.